he's down at the landing.
But why would he have jabbed her several times?
He was drunk. And he woke up and saw her stealing his money. And he just grabbed his knife and nabbed her.
This
is a great place tonight after the tour and when the town quiets down and all the cars are gone that you may want to come and kind of walk around that building and take more pictures. Hello.
Hi.
Taking pictures. Take a lot of pictures.
Referred to the Flegels.
You mean New Disney or Walt Disney?
Walt Disney was in the cartoons, the bad guys.
And
we had two. We had two brothers, Jake and Ralph. And they were bank robbers out of California. And they had robbed banks out there. As a matter of fact, Jake's wife was still in jail in California when they came through. And they robbed. They got to Colorado and robbed a big bank there. They shot and killed the bank president. They also killed the bank president's son, who worked at the bank. They got $230,000. This is in 1930.
Oh my God!
Which has yet to ever be found. They kidnapped the head cashier and later a doctor from the region because one of their gang members had been shot and they needed the doctor, telling both of them that if they cooperated, that they would turn them loose when they got to a safe place, which they did turn them loose and then shot them both in the back. These were not nice guys. So by this time, they are on the top 10 most wanted in the United States, the Flegal Gang. Here's a picture of Jake Flegal.
I never get a picture of that.
I know, we're having a little wind here.
I hope it doesn't reflect that.
Now the family had, the Flegals had family down in Kansas. And so they went from the Colorado bank down to Kansas and was hiding out with the family at a farm. And the authorities got word of it and raided the farm. They caught all the gang and Ralph Flegal, but Jake got away. About 2 months later, that the Colorado governor got a letter asking for leniency for Ralph Flegal in the murder trial, and it was from the Ozark area. So they figured this has got to be Jake. There's no one else that would be asking for leniency for Ralph. So they decided to try a sting operation right here at this station. They put out a rumor that there was a shipment of gold and cash coming in on the local train. And this was October of 1930. And hoping that Jake would bite the bait and try to rob this train, which he did. He was here on that day. However, instead of gold and cash on board, it was federal marshals. And so there was a big shootout. Jake was shot, and he got him to a hospital in Springfield where he died a few hours later. I do have a picture of Jake as he's being taken off the deck here by the marshals. It's hard to see, kind of. There's Jake. There's the marshals on each side of him, and marshals Aww. Over here as they're taking him off the deck.
1 second, I need to get the picture of it.
Now, over the years, the people here at the station feel that Jake is still here trying to rob this train. They say that file drawers in the office open and close by themselves. There's an overhead fan inside that even when the doors and windows are closed, will suddenly start spinning. Customers have said that it felt like somebody was trying to pick their pocket or pull their purse strap away from them. And I had a lady last summer who got swatted on the backside as she walked down the aisle, whirled around, thought her husband had done it. He wasn't within reach and no one else was either. So Jake is the trickster of all of our ghosts in town. Last year we got a picture of someone sitting on this bench. We usually don't even come up on the deck. We only, because they've asked us not to, but I brought you up here because it's raining. But last year we got a picture of someone sitting on a bench up here when we're standing there and there's no one on that bench. I had a lady with a video camera that in three of the frames showed somebody standing behind those brown posts where you are right there. And next to the chain. And I hit, stepped away from the post. And, we're standing there looking at this video in these three frames. It was totally three-dimensional. Tall man, dark blue denim shirt, like he's hiding behind the post and peeking around it. And three frames showed that in her video. And this year we had a image of a floating laughing head. So Jake is still here, and he is the trickster of the bunch. So watch your step when we do leave here, because about 3 weeks ago now, one of our guides got pushed off that step by some unseen force. When you go home and check your pictures, be sure to look in windows and doorways. Now, this is one of those places that you're going to have a lot of reflection between the metal, the glass, the lights on, the lights around us. There's a lot of interference.